Hey, everybody. James Paxton is on the mound today against the Rays in the series finale. Here's a look at a new pitch he's been working on this season. Okay, so before I get to the final game of the series against the Rays, I wanted to take a second to talk about Mike Francesa, the recently retired for the third or fourth time WFAN broadcaster, who went out of his way to disgrace the memory of Horace Clark for no reason. Look at this tweet. This is from Mike Francesa on August 8th. He says, "Horace Clark was the symbol of the Yankees' fall from grace post-1964. He was mediocre just like the Bombers from 65 through 74, RIP. Wow, what a eulogy. Horace Clark just died a couple of days ago, and that was what Mike Francesa thought would be appropriate to post on Twitter. Way to go, Mike. No one delivers a eulogy quite like you. Hole. So we got the unfortunate but yet unsurprising news yesterday that Giancarlo Stanton is out again with an injury. This guy is made of glass. Made of glass. And he pulled his hamstring, apparently his left hamstring. He went for an MRI last night after the game. Actually, we don't know if it's a pull yet. It might be a strain. But either way, he's going on the injured list after 15 games. What a surprise. Less than one-tenth of what would have been a regular season. And we all know that with hamstring troubles, it can take like a month. So we're going to lose Giancarlo Stanton for pretty much the rest of the season, to be honest with you. He might be back near the end of September. We'll see. That's just speculation on my part, but just going from his past history, he's a slow healer. If you remember last year, he was supposed to miss a couple of days with a bicep injury, ended up missing over a month, comes back, hurts his knee in the second or third game back, goes down for another couple months, comes back, pulls his quad or his whatever in the postseason. So Giancarlo Stanton has a history of being injured. Regardless of his injury, the onus is now on the Yankees to replace those at-bats. And that's not an easy bat to replace. Giancarlo had a 1.038 OPS this year, second on the team to Aaron Judge. He's a beast up there when he's in the lineup. He hits the ball as hard as anybody in the league, and he can embarrass you with these long home runs. So we're about to find out who the Yankees think is the best hitter without a position, because Giancarlo Stanton has just been DHing. That's it. He has yet to play the field this year. They were doing that to keep his legs healthy. Well, that didn't work out. So I think they're going to call up either Clint Frazier or Miguel Andujar. You could make a case that Mike Ford could get some of those at-bats against right-handed pitchers and that they'll use somebody like an Andujar or a Frazier against lefties. For now, let's just talk about Andujar and Frazier, because those are the two guys that could be called up. Mike Ford is already on the roster. He's already hitting. Luke Voit is hitting, so those guys are splitting time at first base. You got to imagine some of them will get, one of them will get DH at-bats. But let's see who the Yankees call up. So first, let's talk about Clint Frazier. Last year, he was pretty good when Giancarlo went down. He came up. He did a nice job. He hit 12 home runs. The problem with Clint Frazier was always his defense. In the outfield, he's just atrocious. He's one of the worst defensive outfielders in baseball. But he's got lightning-quick hand speed. He's got a great bat. We saw him hit a monster home run during the scrimmage games against the Mets over at Citi Field, where he went in the second deck. He's just got incredible power, and he's been swinging the bat very, very well down at the alternate site. Now, Miguel Andujar has already been with the team this year. In case you haven't been following, he's had several at-bats, but he has not done anything with them. But I feel like a part of that is that he's not getting regular, consistent at-bats. You know, he was starting for a game here, a game there, but he's mostly been on the bench. And with hitting, especially with a guy like Andujar, who's a reaction-type hitter, where he's got quick hands and he's almost got that Alfonso Soriano or Hank Aaron type of swing where he's a wrist hitter, your timing has to be good. And so he just was not getting enough at-bats to really develop any kind of consistency. I don't know what he's been doing since they sent him down to the alternate site. We're just going to call that AAA from now on because I hate saying the alternate site for some reason. But I really think that it's going to be one of those two guys. Personally, if Miguel Andujar has looked healthy down there in the alternate site, I would give him the at-bats just because he's got a better track record. In 2018, he had an OPS over 800. He hits for power. He hits line drives. He makes contact. Clint Frazier is not a bad pick, though, because he works the count. He's got power. We've seen what he can do, but he doesn't have nearly the track record that Andujar has in terms of success at the major league level. So there's a case for either of them to be made. Personally, if I was making the decision, I would call up Andujar and give him those at-bats until he shows that he's not performing, and then maybe you call up Frazier later on. I know a lot of you are Frazier fans, and I do like Clint Frazier's bat, and I honestly don't see any reason not to call him up if he's just going to be at DH. It's just my personal preference. I would go with Andujar, but you can't go wrong with Frazier either. All right, so let's talk about James Paxton. James Paxton may be on the bubble a little bit. I've mentioned this several times on this channel, but his first two outings have been pure crap. His fastball is down 6 or 7, 8 miles an hour. That's a lot. That's a big drop. His breaking ball has no bite. His command has been off, and he just has not looked good from the get-go. Now, part of that is probably due to spinal surgery that he had this spring, actually. So that's a big deal. That's a big deal coming back from that surgery. And until he shows that he can do it, I think you have to assume that he can't, because it's really hard to come back from a spinal injury like that and be a world-class athlete. I've seen a lot of guys have trouble with their backs and never be the same. Don Mattingly, anyone? So I get Don Mattingly was a first baseman, but you know, the back is such an important piece of any athletic movement, especially as a pitcher. So I think James Paxton is going to get one more shot today, and if he doesn't show some improved stuff and he has another rough outing, I think you could see him go to the bullpen or go on the injured list or whatever it is. That would be bad for Paxton because he is a free agent after the season and he is pitching for a new contract. But hey, you got to get it done. You got to get it done. And the Yankees do have options. Clark Schmidt is a guy that I know the Yankees see as a future big league piece. And he's just toiling away at the alternate site. By the way, he was on my Twitter the other day gave me a shout out. I pinned it to the top of my Twitter feed. So if you want to go check that out, it's at NYY Recaps. So I'm looking forward to seeing Clark Schmidt get in there. But I just have zero confidence in James Paxton until I see those velocity numbers go back up. Once you see him throwing 96, 97, 98, which he may never do again, let's be honest. But if he gets back up to those numbers, then I'll be like, okay, now it's just a matter of getting reps, getting, you know, into a groove. But right now his stuff is not compatible with the type of pitcher that he is. I've seen a few people mention in the comments that the Yankees should go out and make a trade for a pitcher. I saw Trevor Bauer's name mentioned. He's a guy that I mentioned on the podcast before. I would love for the Yankees to get Trevor Bauer. He's one of the most intellectual pitchers out there. He's really in tune with the analytics and, you know, pitch design, which is something that the Yankees are emphasizing, something that Garrett Cole could probably help with because he's a very similar type of pitcher in terms of studying spin rates, studying tunneling, which is the way that, I don't have my baseball here, but the way that the ball comes out of your hand and you can make several different pitches all come out from the same spot. That's called tunneling because it makes it hard for the hitter to pick up what pitch it is. So I'm a big fan of Trevor Bauer. Plus, he's big on the YouTube community. He's got a YouTube channel, and I feel like if the Yankees had Trevor Bauer, that would be a good chance for me to get a celebrity on this podcast, on this show. So, hey, I'm rooting for James Paxton, first of all. I hope he does well today. This is this is not a rubber game. I was about to say rubber game. This is a chance to save the series and split and basically have no blood lost. Now, I will mention we are 25% of the way through the season. The Yankees have a 2.5-game lead in the East over the Orioles. I don't think the Orioles are a threat because the Yankees play them several more times, and they've won like 18 or 19 straight against the Orioles, something ridiculous. The Rays are a threat, though, as we've seen, and if the Rays win today, they'll be 2 games back with 3/4 of the season left to go, and the Yankees obviously down one of their big bats. So this is going to be a season unlike any other And when it's a shortened season and there's so much leverage on every game, I don't think you can afford to give a ton of starts to a guy who just doesn't have it. And it's clear to me at this point that James Paxton has not had it so far this season. So let's hope he can turn it around. I am not confident. I will be back after the game with full highlights of his performance. Please like and subscribe. Please share this channel with anybody you know who likes baseball news. I'm struggling with the algorithm trying to get as many views on this as I think I can. But hopefully this channel will continue to grow throughout the season and will really take off before the postseason. Thanks to everybody who gets involved. If you tweet at me or comment, I will try and respond. And I'll see you after the game.